My people made a speech, so actually, marijuana in America. I originally wanted to talk about the advantages and like disadvantages, but I'll just put that off in my persuasive speech. So, whenever I hear about the drug marijuana, it just occurs to me about a substance that's really powerful, like we change your brain chemistry, like literally take you to a different zone, like make you feel better. Some people doesn't make them feel better. So, basically, today I'm going to be focusing on the history of marijuana and the reasons why marijuana is actually illegal. I was doing some research and I found this out. So most of us, we don't actually know about the history of marijuana, how it came into the United States. So I decided that would be cool if I share that with you. So I just thought about it. This is Christopher Columbus. He's a voyager. You guys remember him in the European expansion. He was actually the guy who brought marijuana into America, not the United States in particular, to the North America. So, and in 1611, that was the first time marijuana actually came into the United States of America. And the first place that was actually introduced it was in Jamestown, Virginia. It was brought in by the English. And a few years later, about 8 years later, a law was passed in Jamestown, Virginia to actually require farmers to grow marijuana. And also, at the same time, if any farmer was actually refused or went against the law to produce this drug or to grow this plant, they were actually arrested. I got this information from brains.org. I know it's actually accurate because I found a lot of them in different sites as well. So, in the book. So as marijuana started spreading quickly around the United States of America, it quickly became a commercial crop and was sold alongside with tobacco. And it was usually grown for its fiber. Particular was used to like create fabrics and different clothes, which brings me to this fact that the first fabric actually made known to man was actually created from the hemp plant. Also, I don't know if most of you guys know this, but marijuana actually had presidential use. George Washington and Thomas Jefferson actually grew their own marijuana in their farms. They didn't use that for recreational purposes. They were actually growing that for like trade and fiber. And medical use of marijuana was actually began in 1840 and was available in the United States pharmacies as early as that time. Recreational use. Around 1920, that was the period when the recreational use of marijuana actually sparked. And during that period, it was referred to as the Reefer Madness. Marijuana was actually restricted to just jazz musicians and show business owners, but individuals began making use of this marijuana just for recreational purposes, and that led to the substance abuse. And because of this abuse of the marijuana plant, Prohibition Act of 1937 began. Marijuana was actually first prohibited by California, which is kind of ironic right now, because California is one of the states in the United States that has actually legalized marijuana for like medical purposes. And they were the first states to actually pass a law against it. And they also assumed that marijuana was dangerous and like harmful to the body. I found three reasons specifically for the reason why marijuana was actually prohibited, but the reason why it was prohibited is not certain for sure. But according to Charles Thomas, the executive director of Interfaith Drug Policy Initiative, he said one of the reasons why marijuana was prohibited was because of the lack of powerful advocates. Most of the powerful advocates that were supposed to be that were powerful enough to make this drug legalized were actually the ones who were against it. That's why marijuana right now is currently illegal. Also, marijuana is illegal because of the perception of harm. And according to Mason Turvett, the executive director of SAFER, he said the United States was actually made this drug illegal because of the belief it's actually harmful to the human body. Because of the fact it alters your brain chemistry, could increase the level of dopamine and prevent your body from producing enough dopamine to sustain it, which in turn leads to the addiction people face today. And also, conspiracy. Matthew Edward, an attorney at law, believes that that the reason why marijuana was actually prohibited and made illegal was just as a result of corporate conspiracy. He believes that to this day, that marijuana was prohibited just so that it could serve a purpose for law enforcement and also provide jobs for like cops, because then they'll have a reason to arrest people and like prevent them from smoking. And finally, Rob Campion, executive director of Marijuana Policy Project, said that the reason why marijuana is illegal is because of that is what we want. Only about 36% of the United States population actually are actually for marijuana, being legal. So which leaves around 64% of the population against it or are not even concerned about this problem. So the government each and every day like billions of dollars into the prohibition of marijuana, and nobody's able to stand up for this because there are people for marijuana, actually just a little population of the whole country in general. With all that being said, marijuana has come a long way from being useful for trade and gifts and making fiber and clothes to now we see marijuana as a probably scum of the earth, a condemned kind of plant that's actually harmful to the human body. Thank you.